Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zollo Tech, and today Apple released iOS 14 Developer Beta 2. This is available to developers only at this point, and maybe the public beta will be out by the time you're watching this, but you just don't know what Apple's going to do until they release it. So expect public beta 1 either later today, tomorrow, or maybe they'll wait a week or two. It's hard to say what Apple's going to do with it. Hopefully it's out by the time you're watching this. Now, this came in at 831.5 megabytes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and it was similarly sized on all of these devices. It's a pretty large update, and I'm still having that storage bug. I'll talk about that in a moment. Now, along with iOS 14 Beta 2, Apple also released iPad OS 14 Beta 2, Mac OS Big Sur Beta 2, Watch OS 7 Beta 2, TV OS 14 Beta 2, and while HomePod OS did not get updated, iOS 14 Beta 2 now allows you to select default music apps for it. So I actually am not at a place where my HomePod is, but you'll see you can actually select default music apps on your HomePod. Let's take a look at the build number and then talk about everything new. The build number is 18A5319I, and the last build number ended in V, so we've come up quite a few. The closer we get to the letter A, the closer we are to a finished product. So that's quite a lot of progress in a couple weeks, and there's quite a lot of fixes in this particular update. The first thing is there is a modem update, at least for the iPhone 11 Pro Max. There may or may not be, depending on which device you have, but I have one on this device. Also, there were 55 known issues that still exist, according to Apple's notes. So just keep that in mind. This is still an early beta. There's bound to be bugs, but so far it's been pretty good. But there's 43 resolved issues. So one of the resolved issues is this weather widget should now show up properly based on where you're located. It was kind of defaulting back to Cupertino, so they've resolved that. And also AR7, that makes wallpapers that sometimes I use in these videos, has said that the faded wallpaper problem has been resolved for him. So I haven't seen that issue myself, but hopefully it's resolved for you. Now the first feature I wanted to talk about isn't really in the area I live, but if you go into Maps, and you live in an area that has congestion zones that charge tolls, such as maybe Paris or London, those will now pop up in Maps. Also, there will be alerts for license plate restriction zones if your country has that as well. So we don't have that, at least where I live, but if you're in a country that does have that, well, that should be available in Apple Maps for you to test out. Now, Reminders has been updated with those emojis. Apple talked about this with iOS 14 Beta 1, but we never saw it. And you can see we now have emoji here that you can update. So for family, for example, if I want to go in and change the name and appearance, I can change them to whatever I'd want, change the actual color, change it to an umbrella, whatever you'd like it to be, you can change it. And then when you go back to your lists, you'll see the different emoji. So those have been updated. Now, in the control center, the actual button for whatever you're controlling has grown in size. Some people are seeing this, some people are not, but you'll see mine says Office Favorites. I can tap on this and see my different lights for the room I'm in, and it's just gotten bigger. Some people are not seeing that. There's also a new option for the control center. So if we go into Settings and then the control center, you'll see we now have a new Show Home Controls option. So this is all new as well. And if you don't want home controls, we turn it off, they disappear in your control center, turn it on, and they're back. So I like that they've added that option back, and it's nice to have that. Now, if you're using a camera within the Home app, there's a new option. So you'll see I have a camera. It says Circle View Camera. It's a Logitech HomeKit camera I'm testing out, and it's actually open on another device, so you can't actually see this. But if I go into the camera, and within the camera, we now have an option for picture in picture. Now, the actual picture in picture option was there before as far as swiping up, and it would give you a little picture in picture, but now we have a physical button to make it do that. So after we hit the button, it will shrink into a picture in whatever corner you'd like, and you can move it around. Now, within widgets, there's a few new things as well. So if we go over to our widgets, press and hold, add a widget, we'll scroll down, and you'll see we now have files. So we now have a new file widget. If we open this up, you'll notice here as well, down at the bottom, the color actually matches the icon. So if we go out of this, maybe we go to batteries, you'll see the battery widget icon down here to add a widget now matches. Now we also have an update as well when it comes to the photos widget. So if we go into photos, we now have a larger size for photos as well. So I just have it blurred out since it's family, but it's a larger photo size that you have for a widget option. Apple's now updated the calendar app so it shows the abbreviation of the actual weekday. So you'll see here it says Tuesday or TUE. And on the old version with beta 1, it has the full word written out. So you'll see here, it's abbreviated in beta 2. It's the full word in beta 1. This could change, of course, in the future. Now with the app library, Apple makes it super convenient to find your apps and everything else. But one thing you couldn't do before is if you added an app specifically directly right into the app library and not on one of your screens, you couldn't delete it before. And so if we go into productivity, for example, wherever that is, we'll go into productivity, tap and hold on the calendar, you'll see it says delete app. If I do the same thing on beta 1, it's not going to let me delete it the same way. So we'll tap and hold. And you'll see it says add event to screen or to the home screen or add an event. You can't delete the app. So if you added it directly to the list, you can now delete it like you should be able to from the start. Now there's a couple updates for music. One is a new option. So if we go into our settings and then scroll down until we find music, under music, we now have an option for motion. And it says animated cover art won't be displayed. It's currently turned on. We can have it on for Wi-Fi only or have it turned off altogether. This just uses a little extra data, so they're giving you that option. Within the music app, they've also updated haptic feedback so that it responds when you press play, or maybe you press next or back or fast forward or rewind. You press those buttons, you get a little haptic feedback from the phone itself, letting you know you've pressed it. It's a nice little touch that's been updated. It's very subtle, but it is there. Now within settings, if we go to settings and then our ID at the top, you'll see family sharing, and family sharing has a new icon. So it says family sharing, and we have a new icon here. It's just been updated with a little new look. Now, the iPad does not have a whole lot new, but there is something new specific to the iPad, and that's under photos. So if we go into photos and then bring over our sidebar here, we now have a utilities section that has imports hidden and recently deleted. So that's actually been updated. That wasn't there before. It's just a little addition to the sidebar. And I imagine we'll see more of these things later on with the iPad. But the iPad gets all of the different updates that I've mentioned already, although some of the haptic feedback won't be there. There's a couple other little changes. One of them has to do with the health app. So if we go into the health app, we'll scroll down a little bit, and there's a new article for hand washing saying hand washing can protect your health. Now, if you're running watchOS 7, you'll have the option for hand washing if you have a Series 4 or Series 5. And you can go into the article, learn about this, and also turn it on from the health app if it's not already turned on. So you have that option. It's something I've already got on. I'm not seeing the option, but some are seeing that option. Now, something else that's very minor that's been changed is the clock icon. You can see the hands. They're slightly bigger than they were before. So if I bring in beta 1 here, let me bring it over, and you can see side by side that the clock hands are slightly different. So they're a little bit different on each clock. They're a little bit thicker on the newer version. It's a minor update, and Apple could change it back before it's released to the public. Now, one final thing is the Shortcuts app will no longer open .shortcut files anymore. So I have a few shortcuts I've made. I did a video on this some time ago. Let's download one that's from my website. As you can see, we'll go to Activity, open it up, and it says shortcuts cannot be opened. Importing shortcuts as files is not currently supported. Please share shortcuts using iCloud. Hopefully they bring this back. It was working before, and it's something that they definitely need to update, but it could just be a bug for now. And then finally, many people have been complaining about using email for quite some time, but one thing that really bugs me is I actually can't highlight and then drag my finger to delete the email anymore. This was true with beta 1. They haven't fixed this, so make sure to report it in feedback. It's definitely something I'd like to see brought back. You used to be able to just tap on one and then slide your finger down and select all of them. It was a really easy way to select a lot of email. Now that's it for this particular update. There may be a few other things, but I wanted to talk about performance. We'll talk about battery and take a look at some of the Geekbench scores. Now, the first thing is the battery. Battery life on iOS 14 beta 1 was not fantastic for me. So if we go into the battery, you'll see my battery health is at 97%, completely normal for the age of the phone. 80% after 2 years is normal, and updates don't degrade this. They just simply check for it again. But if we take a look at the last 10 days, I've been running this every day. Let's take a look at yesterday. You'll see I used almost 50% of the battery and only got 2 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 15 minutes of screen off time. That's not really that good. I used to get 10 to 12 hours of screen on time and then maybe 5 hours of screen off time. Right now, the battery life isn't great, although it may be a little bit better than it says, because right now it says I have 61% of my battery life left. And for today, it's 2 hours and 49 minutes. It's really hit or miss. I'm getting about 6 hours most of the time, maybe 8 hours at best, but hopefully they'll update it with this particular update and it will fix that issue. Now, other than battery life, my storage isn't great. So maybe there's something correlated. It's maybe filling some cache up or something like that. So if we take a look at my storage, you'll see my storage is still using a huge amount. 250 gigabytes of 256 gigabytes are used. Previous to this, I'm using about 60 gigabytes on a 256 gigabyte phone, 60 to 80 or something like that. Right now I'm using a huge amount in other. So I was hoping this update would fix that automatically. You can fix it by restoring on a computer, but I really didn't want to do that if I don't have to. Now, as far as performance, I've noticed a couple things so far on the older phone. And so, for example, on the iPhone SE, when I was typing in a password, when I was setting this up with the latest update, it wanted me to re-verify some things, the keyboard would freeze quite a lot. So if I go into music and then go to search and type in maybe, I guess, an artist here, capitalize it, a lot of the times the keyboard will just freeze and not work properly. I noticed that when putting in my password a couple times. So it was really kind of a pain. The performance wasn't great, but maybe it was doing a lot of things in the background. As far as the camera and everything else, it's fairly responsive. Scrolling seems to be okay. So far, it's fairly smooth, but if you're having issues, make sure you report them in feedback, because new updates do not tend to slow down iPhones anymore. They seem to be pretty solid that way. So just be sure to check that. Battery life will improve over time. It's not a priority with early betas until it's out to maybe public beta testers and out to the public in general. Apple's focusing on fixing all the bugs that they have with this particular update. Now, if we take a look at the Geekbench scores, you'll see the iPhone 11 Pro Max scored 1,338 for single core, 3,387 for multi-core. That's actually pretty good and much higher than I've seen before. Now, unfortunately, this particular benchmark did not save what I had before. It only has today's, but that may be because the app had to be reinstalled at some point, or maybe with the update. Now let's take a look at all of the different devices here and see what they scored. Now on the left is the 2020 12.9 inch iPad Pro. In the middle is the first generation iPhone SE. And on the right is the iPhone 11 Pro Max. All of the scores are pretty decent this time around. And if your scores are anywhere in this general range, expect similar performance. And sometimes these will increase a little bit too as time goes on and background processing has completed. So that's it for iOS 14 beta 2. Expect a beta every couple of weeks right now, and then it will probably pick up in August to a weekly schedule. Also, we may see iOS 13.6 beta 4 or a final release as soon as tomorrow. So it's hard to say. I think we're going to see beta 4 tomorrow and then maybe a final release the week after that, but it's kind of hard to say at this point. Also, I recently had the iPhone 12 prototype units, and here's one of them. So if you haven't seen the video about that, I'll link it in the description as well. Be sure to check that out and let me know what you think of those as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.